Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. In today's video, I'm going to show you the power of this Home Trio, Home Assistant, Home Bridge, and the Home Kit. Since I started my Home Assistant journey a few years back, I have created few dashboards to have a direct interface with my smart home. But the experience was never as friendly and seamless as it is with Apple Home Kit. With Apple Home app, I don't need any other application for two-way talks on my doorbell or my cameras. I can easily share the control with my friends or guests who are visiting us. I can see the notifications on my Apple TV seamlessly without any additional configurations. Of course, I can control all my smart home devices from my Apple Home app directly. Also, I can use Siri to control all my smart home devices. Best of all these is, it has a very high spouse approval score since Apple Home app is much more user-friendly than the dashboard which I created using Home Assistant. But of course, to make all this work, you must be on Apple ecosystem. Alright, enough of background, let's get to work. So the idea here is to expose smart home devices on HomeKit and control them directly from Apple Home app, even if they are not natively supported by Apple HomeKit. Home Assistant will still be my main home automation platform for integrations and automations. I am just using Apple Home app to manually control my smart home devices and improve the user experience without using native apps from different manufacturers, for example, my Unify Protect application from Ubiquiti. So you will be thinking about, will you be able to add your smart home devices which are not natively supported by HomeKit? Will you be able to make it work without pairing all those devices again with their hubs? Will you be able to do this if you don't own an Apple Home Hub, for example, Apple TV or Apple HomePod? So the answer to all these questions is yes. You will be able to achieve all this without any major changes in your smart home. So let's see what you will need. First one, of course, working installation of Home Assistant with all your smart devices which you want to add to HomeKit. Second is a Home Bridge installation, mainly if you need a two-way audio working on your doorbells or your cameras on your HomeKit app without the need of provider's app. In my case, I'll be using it for my Unify Protect setup, that is the doorbell and the cameras. Ideally, for better control and stability, especially when you're away from your home, you should have an Apple Home Hub like Apple TV or Apple HomePod or even an iPad. Without Apple Home Hub, you will not be able to control your smart home devices remotely. You can still control them while you are connected to your home network. As I said previously, an iPad can be used as a hub if it can be left powered up at home, connected to the internet all the times. If you don't have any of these, you can still add 150 devices under Home Assistant Bridge, but you'll need to add more bridges if you have more devices. Alright, so first step is to add your Home Assistant devices into HomeKit. For this, we will need to add HomeKit Bridge integration. To do that, go to Settings, Devices and Services, and click on Add Integration and search for Apple HomeKit Bridge. You should select only the domains which you want to expose in HomeKit. Some domains like cameras and media players are needed to be set up in accessory mode. You can also expose Home Assistant scripts which you have created in Home Assistant. But these will be exposed as switches. When you turn on a switch, it will send a command to Home Assistant to run the script and then will turn off. For this tutorial, I'll select domains light and climate to expose them into my HomeKit. Click submit. When you click submit, you'll see a message to follow instructions under the Home Assistant notifications. Click submit again and select the location of HomeKit Bridge location and then click Finish. Go to your Apple Home device and open Home app. Tap on the plus icon on the top right corner and then tap Add Accessory. Scan the QR code you are seeing on your Home Assistant instance under the notification. Apple Home app will start adding the bridge, warning you it's not Apple certified. Tap Add anyway, and then you should see all your devices showing up on the Home app. You can organize them if you want. I'll skip this step for now. You should be able to control all these devices from Home app as long as your Home Assistant is up and running. We can expose cameras into HomeKit from Home Assistant as well, but if your cameras support two-way talk, then exposing it with Home Assistant Bridge won't enable you to use that feature. But you still can stream your cameras from Home app. Let's expose cameras in HomeKit and have two-way talk support without the native camera app. In my case, I'll add my Unify doorbell and camera into HomeKit. To get seamless two-way talk experience, I'll be using HomeBridge to get my Unify cameras exposed into HomeKit. For those of you who do not know what HomeBridge is, it's a powerful open source software which allows you to integrate with smart home devices that are not natively supported by HomeKit. So let's install HomeBridge. I'll install HomeBridge on my Synology NAS using Container Manager. It can be installed on other platforms too. I'll share the link to its installation wiki page down in the description below. For Docker Compose installation, click on Docker and scroll down to get Docker Compose YAML file code. Copy the content and go to your Synology NAS. I'm assuming you have already installed and set up Container Manager on your Synology NAS and you have a shared folder called Docker. Get into that folder and create a new folder called HomeBridge. Now open Container Manager and click on Project, click on Create, give it a name and set the path to the folder we just created. Then under Source, select Create Docker Compose and paste the code you copied from HomeBridge website. Make sure your volume path is pointing to HomeBridge folder we just created. Click Next, Next again, and Done. HomeBridge will be downloaded and installed. While this is happening, please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified every time I release a new video about smart home automation, home network security, and storage. Alright, so installation is complete with exit code 0. That means no error occurred during installation, which is good. So now, as per the documentation, I need to access HomeBridge interface using my NAS IP and the port 8581. Alright, so since this is the first time we are registering this page, so we need to complete the setup. I'll create an admin account now to start with. Okay, we are in. We can see the HomeKit code on the dashboard, but we don't need to scan this QR code as of now. We'll first install a plugin for Unify Protect and we'll add it as a bridge in our HomeKit. Click on Plugins and search for Unify Protect. You should see your Verify HomeBridge Unify Protect plugin. By verification, it means the plugin has been developed using the best practices and it has been verified by HomeBridge team. Now click on the blue arrow to download and install it. Once the installation is complete, click on Setup icon. Now to set it up, it is recommended to create a separate account on your Unify controller. If you only want to view the camera feed, then view only account is more than enough. Enter the IP address of your controller and then enter the username and the password you created for HomeBridge. Once the setup is complete, you should see available feature options. I'll leave everything as default and click on Save. You'll see a prompt to reboot HomeBridge. Click on Restart. Once the reboot is complete, click on Accessories. You'll see all the default accessories now added into your HomeBridge. Click on Plugins again. Now you should see HomeBridge Unify Protect as an installed plugin. You should be seeing a child bridge icon to make this plugin as a child bridge. It's highly recommended to use child bridges where you can. This feature allows any home bridge platform or accessory to run as its own independent bridge, separate from main bridge in an isolated process. There are many added benefits to this. For example, it will isolate plugin code from the main bridge. It can restart independently without rebooting the main bridge. It's not impacted by dependency exclusions caused by other plugins. I'll leave the link to Child Bridge documentation down in the description below. Now, on the Child Bridge window, you should see a toggle to run Unify Protect as a Child Bridge. Enable this one and click on Save and restart Home Bridge. Wait for it to come back. Once it's back up and running, you should see Unify Protect Child Bridge on dashboard to quickly reboot it if you want. Now, go back to plugins again and on Unify Protect, click on QR code to pair it with HomeKit. On your Apple Home app, again, click on plus icon and click on add accessory. Scan the QR code. You will see a warning that this is not certified by Apple. That's fine. Tap add anyway and finish the setup. Alright, so time for the magic. Once the Unify Protect cameras are added to your Home app, you can tap on them to stream and talk using the camera's built-in mic and speaker without using any native camera app. I am super impressed with HomeBridge to bring these cameras into HomeKit with even better user experience from native camera app. Alright, so this was a basic tutorial to show you what these big three can do to your smart home. I have been using Home Assistant, HomeBridge and HomeKit extensively in my smart home. Using these three, I only need one Apple Home app to control all my smart home devices with the power of automation and integrations coming from Home Assistant and HomeBridge. Alright, that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. Please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in the next video.